What's up, guys? Welcome back to the Cheesy Dozen Cooking Vlog. Today we're making a beef pot pie, which I learned from one of my favorite chefs. His name is Heston Blumenthal.
I'm Heston Blumenthal.
He's got like 6 Michelin tires. Now, I've never made this before, like, ever. What's the worst that could happen? First, we start by making our beef filling. It consists of beef, veggies, sauce, and stuff. Here I have a ribeye and tri-tip. Cut these into small cubes that are about the size of a small cube. Then separate the fat from the meat. Once you do that, throw out the meat because we're just gonna cook the fat. Cook the fat in a hot pot until tender. You wanna render out all of its goodness and, oh wait, the recipe's upside down. Oh, you cooked the meat, not the fat.
Oops.
I guess that makes more sense. I'll just remove this and pull the meat from the trash. We want to brown this thoroughly. In the meantime, let's prep our veggies. We're going to chop carrots, mushrooms, garlic, and dice an onion. That last transition really sucked. Like, worse than Lance Bass's transition to acting. Or Demi Lovato's transition to sobriety.
Too soon, Junior.
Season the beef with salt, cayenne, and a little sugar to balance it all out. As it's browning, add your veggies and cook out most of the moisture. This will increase flavor exponentially. After that, dig a wishing well and splooge out some of the tomato paste. Cook it out for a few seconds, then mix it with the other crap. Now we're gonna create a roux by adding butter and flour. Next, we're adding red wine, but I forgot to buy some.
Idiot!
So, shopping montage!
Fumble out of bed and I stumble to the kitchen for my soul. Shower and the blood starts pumping out on the streets. The traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Ah! Working 9 to 5. What a
somebody. You want to add a red wine that's not too sweet, something like a Chianti or a Cabernet. Scrape up all the sides and bottom to get all the flavor. Once the booze is burned off, add beef stock and let it simmer. Add some star anise. This is an aromatic spice. It goes really well with beef. If you have trouble finding it at the store, it's the one that looks like a confused butthole. Also some thyme, a bunch of pepper, and I didn't film it, but add some bay leaves. Turn it to low and let it simmer for 3 hours uncovered. It's been 3 hours. The sauce is reduced and thickened. Give it a taste for salt and pepper. Mine tasted absolutely perfect and was definitely not too salty, because this is the internet, so whatever I say is completely true. Are you calling me a cheater? I have never cheated. You don't know me. You're a liar and a thief. Tell him, Serena.
You owe me an apology. I have never cheated in my life.
Grab a cupcake pan and pour some oil into each of the slots. Then finger blast away until the cups are well coated. Next, grab some puff pastry and line the edges. Don't worry about it being perfect. I'll still love you, even though Instagram won't. Load up your cups with this beefy gush. Don't overfill it. We still need to cover this. As you can see, peas have magically appeared. I thought this was a really good idea, but after further review, it added nothing to the dish. It might be stupider than parsley, so just ignore them. When filled, wrap up the cups. If you have extra pastry, cap it off. The top will be the bottom anyway, so don't worry about presentation. I had some extra puffin stuff, so I made a dog turd. Pop all this in the oven at 425 degrees for 25 minutes or until the pastry is golden brown. The turd didn't make it, but the rest is pretty dope. One last thing I'm gonna do before serving this. I reduced the remaining sauce while my buns were in the oven. In the recipe, Heston injects sauce into the final product. I don't know why, maybe he's like into drugs and stuff. Okay, moment of truth. Alright, that was a train wreck, but regardless, this thing was good, like real good. Very deep beefy flavors, crispy pie crust, I mean, the old Brit knows what he's talking about. However, I need to do the slow-mo cut again for my own pride, because that was terrible. This time I'll use a knife. Still looks like shit.
That's it for today, guys. Make sure you look at Sissa. Follow me everywhere at Cheesy Does It Cooking. As usual, the recipe and ingredients are in the blog, link in the description below. I'm running all out of outro ideas, so let's just go scare somebody. Okay, that was so stupid. Thank you for 500 subscribers. Let's go for 501. Just got paid.